Now, the quality of this forehand is very impressive, and it has been. But I think if it's just a step behind the table, speed is going to be a tough way to beat Sun Yingsha. She's going to have to stay close here, follow the serves.
Left, love one.
Deep on the table, and the fight starts now. From the very first point, this is going to be a battle if Hina Hayata has anything to say about it.
Two powerful forehands cross court. Lovely, lovely shots to get on the board.
Ooh, headshot. Man, when I said it was going to be a fight, I didn't mean literally. It was just a figurative thing. That's the thing with the word literally in 2021. It doesn't mean anything anymore. Obviously not intentional. Edge ball off the racket there from Shasha. Now, in case you're concerned for Hina Hayata's safety, as long as it doesn't hit an open eye, players tend to be fine with the ball hitting them. It's light. Ah, nice touch here, causing the hesitation. I use the term half long a lot for serves, but even in the rally, that half long push is so important. Abbreviated stroke here, a short forehand from Hina Hayata. Good compactness from the tall player.
Yeah, she's playing very well so far, targeting Yingsha's backhand. And playing with a little more pace. But Yingsha's going to settle down quickly, and she's going to get many more balls back.
Interesting. Change of pace, a bit of a floating backhand that just sort of carries low over the net from Hayata. Here's the push. Half long, but that shot right there, very unusual. You could see it kick off the bounce.
Yeah.
Bit of side spin on it.
Yeah.
Now the variation in the push game from Hina Hayata is making it very difficult right now for Sun Yingsha to do what she does so well. Turn the corner and hit that winner. Again, that side spin backhand, but this time well calibrated. Shasha has an answer.
This time, Yingsha was in a very good position to play that forehand topspin cross court.
This feels like a good change of pace. Yes, it's a fast shot, but it's not the fastest she can hit. She's not taking, say, a full stroke with the backhand. Just sort of an abbreviated, compact punching shot. A little topspin on it. But again, it's a rhythm breaker. Half long. Even though it comes off the table, it's not comfortable to do anything with.
Yeah, it's played to her extreme forehand, and that ball had enough spin. It was moving away from her forehand all the time.
Baseline and a lot of spin. Long pushes, when they're surprising, well-placed and quick, can be very effective.
Yeah, Yingsha just making a few errors on that forehand topspin, but look at this deep return from Hayata. Very, very good.
She does a good job of combining side spin in her game to bring some question as to how much backspin, how much side spin is on the ball. Cracking forehand and a 5-point lead. Now the first game, again, Hina Hayata would not be the favorite to win this match coming into it. Sun Yingsha has been dominating the game. The greatest threat to China, Mima Ito, hasn't been able to beat her in a long time. That said, this first game is going to be very important for Hina Hayata to keep confidence and keep Sun Yingsha in a bit of a sweat or a stressful situation.
Left, 5-9.
it is. Big forehand on the step around. The way she gets that left leg out of the way to create room for the forehand. I mean, that was some quick, fancy footwork.
Yeah, very impressive indeed from Hayata. She's taking the game to Sung Sha. She's attacking first, playing some very good shots. Lot of pace.
One game point save. Still four to go for Hina Hayata on screen. The left-handed taller player tries to stay loose. Tries to stay positive. You'll see positive head shakes just before the point starts, even after losing points from the Japanese women's team. Oh, back edge of the table, the bending backhand. A bit of fortune, but a strong performance here. There seems to be sort of a lightness about her. Maybe Mima Ito set the tone with that. Good defense, but when you get that far from the table with Sun Ying Sha on the other side, there's just too much ground to cover, even if you're 5'7" and fast.
How quick was Ying Sha this time? Four consecutive forehand topspins played by her.
Now the distance from the table, Hina Hayata cannot afford to be there. There's not that much difference, but it all just adds up. And that little bit of timing gives too much control to Sun Ying Sha. Well, she's trying, but the serve here, again, a very keen receive. Sun Ying Sha stealing the attack with the backhand on the opening.
The serve just slightly long from Hayata.
Funny, I wonder what percentage of fans here are actually players themselves. The Popeye duo in the front row was sort of discussing and analyzing. I wonder if they're getting ready, taking notes as well, video to study. A lot of inspiration in front of them. At the towel break, I want to talk more about the smiles on court and Mima Ito.
Left, 3-1. Left.
We've seen a lot of three lets in a row today.
Yeah, I wanted to ask you a question on that, Adam. Do you think the rule will ever come into play where let calls are legal and the point continues in table tennis?
I wouldn't rule it out, no pun intended.
Let.
Wow, four in a row. Go, go, go. Honestly, I mean, we all need to sleep at some point, but I would stay well past midnight just to watch someone serve 100 lets in a row to say I saw it live. Oh, the streak came to an end, a serve that came into play. That backhand, so good over the table. She creeps in, getting aggressive on the receive. Smart.
Stop. No flashlight, please.
Oh, good umpiring. Kirsten Duchamp's making sure that the players can see clearly, that there are no flashes on cameras. Ooh, back edge of the table again. Is it game point in game one? Yeah, it was.
Yes, it was, yeah.
You know, the interesting thing, whenever someone asks me a question about predicting the future, I tend to decline because predicting the future, as I've heard before, is a great exercise in humility. It's very easy to be wrong about that. But I think, yeah, it definitely could happen. I like to think about how it would affect the sport. I read YouTube comments, which is probably not advised by anyone who's ever read more than two, but it's interesting to see the conversations and how people feel.
I'm just saying it because it'll quicken up the game.
Right.
For no other reason.
Are you hungry? The food's been so good here. Thank you, Singapore. Ooh. A little bit of table tennis karma. Sun Ying Sha still got a few in the bank. Look at the smiles. They're the smiles. Hina Hayata looking jovial. think a big part of that could be to stay loose.
Yeah. She's enjoying herself. I think she needs to. I mean, she has nothing to lose in this match, but she's going to give it all. But she's going to enjoy this moment.
YOLO.
Let five.
I thought you were going to say that. I thought you were going to say, I mean, YOLO. Five serving three. Shasha with two on her racket. Now, this is the bottle challenge serve. When a righty is playing a lefty, I mean, Lin Yunru uses this incredibly well, that long serve to the backhand of his right-handed opponents. And a right-hander can do that to a left-hander as well. Very secure spin shots from Shasha to keep her positioning near the table.
Hayata just backed off after the return of serve went slightly high, and that's why she was in that tough situation.
It's a natural thing to do when you see Sun Yingxia pull back and prepare to attack. Oh! That ball was as cozy with the net as can be, just cuddling up against it.
Yeah, you can't get a tighter net shot than this one.
I mean, the ball in the net right now. Geez, get a room.
Two bounces on the net.
Shasha quick, but withstanding the heat coming in and a racket high, it is Hayata. So 2 points between them here at the second towel break. Mima Ito, you'll see her smiling, and I think there's been a lot of misunderstanding from, well, I don't know, supporters of her strongest opponents in the world. They might take it as cockiness or something to that effect, but for her, it's just trying to relax, to stay loose, fluid at the table. Oh, down the line. Outstanding shot. Clobbers this ball with no remorse.
Amazing shot from Hayata. A good forehand topspin, but look at that ball taken so early, almost on the bounce.
I hope someone takes a screenshot of that finishing pose and creates a silhouette for a brand logo. It was just picture perfect. And showing she can do the same with the backhand on the backhand side, Shasha maintaining her lead of 2 points.
Yeah, that's a very low percentage shot that Yingxia was playing there, but just continued attacking the backhand of Hayata. Gets a 2 point cushion.
And behind the table, that extra spin from the Chinese forehand. Again, it's a heavy, hard rubber that's very slow in the short game, but with that full arm stroke that you see from Shasha, it gets so much racket speed. I'm trying to remember the first headshot, the first two, I think, were at Hayata.
Yeah.
Not personal. Duck and cover moment. Shasha keeping it cool. And as cool as can be with four game points to tie it up. Quality shots here. Brave for Sun Yingxia to move back into the table during such a high-octane rally.
Yeah, there was one shot here by Hayata. I mean, she just turned defense into attack, really took that ball early and played the cross-court shot.
Still three game points left. Second serve for Shasha. Very strong opening attack here. Hayata over the table gets in for that backhand receive. Third towel break. Trying to think. I want to say Astana, the 2017 World Tour Grand Finals. Hina Hayata really caught my eye playing one of the top Chinese players in the later rounds of the tournament. And that was essentially the previous version of this year-ending celebration. Only the top 16, or 16 of the top women.
Thank you.
If I heard that correctly, it was don't take so much time. Please don't stall. Warning from the umpire. Ooh, this is a bit of a tomahawk serve. Moves over to the forehand side. You can see how sharp that ball bent on the second bounce. This camera angle will be perfect for it.
Yep, and you see the side spin on the ball. Yingxia was shaping up to play the backhand topspin. Couldn't connect. Hayata has saved 3 game points.
Trying for a similar serve, a sign of confidence here from Sun Yingsha to hit it back into her side of the table. Bit of swagger under pressure. Oh, what a point from Shasha, withstands a few big shots. The way Shasha goes for this last shot, it was so free. She looked like a discus thrower. The arms just completely across the body. Watch one more time. Driven behind the table right there. Hina Hayata doesn't give up. She keeps it deep with topspin. And Ishida in the corner right there. Coach Ishida with his hands over his head. Just the first point.
One, oh.
A short shot, not a head shot. What are you thinking?
I think she was right to go for that one. I mean, after the returns from the last point, she must have been full of confidence. So she's thinking, if I get high balls, I'm going to go for the winners.
This rally had 4 nets in it, but the last one didn't come down on the table. Hayata acknowledging the fortune.
The control shown by both these players is amazing. Both trying to keep the ball short to prevent the other from attacking.
Good tight serve here inside the table. Not an easy flick. It's so low, and it gets a passive receive out of Hayata, trying to keep it tight to the net. Double serve inside the table, a very ambitious and aggressive Sun Yingsha. She'll make that shot sometimes, but a very tight serve from Hayata to make it difficult.
She has pulled off that cross-court forehand shot, played with a lot of pace before. So she's going to continue trying that. The ball was there for her to hit it, but maybe not as flat as she did. She could have gone for the loopy forehand topspin instead. But she's taking her chances, and she's playing very, very good shots.
There it is. Early in the match in game one, Hina Hayata gave a similar push, a little bit more empty, and it was over looped. But we've seen Sun Yingsha do this devastating shot so many times. Oh, the slow-mo, she looks like a superhero. The hair moves first, then the hips, then the shoulders, and last, the hand is just a flash of light. Nice exit angle here, Hayata going risky on the wide line.
Yeah, many times she's gone for that cross-court forehand. And this one is actually moving away from the backhand of Yingsha. It's going away from the side of the table.
Funny, I see a Singapore lion there in the front row. I remember Liam Pitchford was interviewed about the lion on his forearm. This guy in the red shirt here has got the Singapore lion on his table tennis outfit. One point game, Hina Hayata with a big serve here. The idea is right. And it's very tricky to find these wide angles as you start to get behind the table. Hayata trying to keep close, but maybe not close enough in this rally to play such a wide shot. Good pressure from Sun Yingsha, deep on the table with topspin time and time again. What a recovery from Shasha. Keeps her cool, readjusts. Very impressive play.
Yeah, there was so much of spin on that return from Hayata, but Yingsha did very well. Closed the face of her bat, of her racket, and really did well to win that point. one of the few aces. The ball moving away from her forehand, but I think the umpires called it a net.
Well, if it was, the umpire has better eyes than we do. And that wouldn't be the first time. I think Ingrid Bogren of Sweden made one of the most amazing calls in table tennis history during the Women's World Cup final with Liu Shiwen and Zhu Yuling.
You know, in the days when I was playing, those were the ancient days, if a ball like this hit the net and hit your racket, you actually got the point. Yep.
You're younger than that. I'm looking at you right now. There's no way.
I'm telling you, if the ball would come straight onto your racket, the point would be yours.
What do you eat? The topspin coming in, Hina Hayata showing her youth and vibrance out here, just like my co-commentator. Very spinny forehand. I'm gonna have so many questions for you after this session. 4 points in front, Sun Ying Sha. But the serve's on her side now.
Nine, six.
Just got a little caught up there. Not able to move the full body out of the way to play that down the line.
Getting our money's worth here in this match. The types of points that we're seeing between these two. Hina Hayata showing that she's capable to fight with the best in the world. But Sasha right now with 4 game points for a 2-1 lead. A steady spin from the forehand side. You say this game is for Hina Hayata in this best of 7 match.
I think she absolutely needs to win it. I don't think she can come back from 1-3 down to win, you know, 3 games in a row. I think that's a little bit too much to ask. But she's going to give it everything she has.
One will not come down on the table. Hayata with the pressure keeps Sun Ying Sha behind.
Playing very well this point on both flanks, getting Ying Sha in an uncomfortable position.
How casual did Sun Ying Sha look? I mean, the point ended, my eyes immediately went over to her, and it looked like she had ended the point in her mind, like, before I even looked at her.
Not 1-2.
I like that. Just the honor system in general. Players respect each other, they say, okay. Good placement into the elbow. Now, taller players, there are pros and cons to being tall in table tennis. If there were more pros than cons by any significant margin, table tennis players would all be tall, but they're not. All shapes and sizes. The advantages, reach, maybe strength. Disadvantages, your middle is easier to hit to and it's tougher to recover. You have to get low because the table stays in the same place. It's not like a strike zone in baseball. The table is where it is and the player has to, well, conform to the table.
Beautiful serve from Ying Sha. A lot of side spin on the ball, and Hayata was just trying to place the ball deep. was very close to the edge of the table, but extremely good serve by Ying Cha. She takes a 2-point lead now. And she has a 2-1 lead as well.
Let 2-4.
Even on that lead service, you could see how sharp the turn was of the ball. Right there? Did you say good? Oh, I thought I heard good. Some good play, and indeed, Hayata within one. And a quality long push, surprising fast near the baseline. Shasha using a long push very effectively here.
Yeah, and straight to the body of Hayata down the center of the table. Very good serve again. She's really making full use of her serves. Hayata is trying to play the attacking shots, but it's just not coming out long enough for her to play.
Soft touch just behind the net. Hayata drops it short. Still within two ways to go. She's been chasing most of this game. A gift. Songgimi. A gift to Shasha on the receive. But this is the risk. I mean, for someone just tuning in, if this is the first point they saw, they have to make the most incredible serves that are so high risk. You can't serve lukewarm at this level. If you serve without a clear intention, without thinking about it, well, usually you're going to pay for that quickly.
Ying Cha has always been ahead in this fourth game. And here are two serves to try and go ahead even further.
How was Shasha not bothered by that receive? I mean, she took every, it was like she was unthreading that ball. I know there's no thread on it. Oh, the receive, though. Let's see if we can grab that. So 4 points ahead now. Shasha just 2 points away from 3-1. Watch Hayata touch this. Ready? Strawberry, just a side slicing shot there, taking all the pace off it. Never really pulled up the back of the racket, though. That straight side spin. That bothers a lot of players. It throws a wrench in the system, you know?
Yeah, you're just not ready for that kind of return. You don't know whether to attack it, to just get it back across the table.
Good length here, right near the baseline, jamming up Shasha. That's what half long is all about.
Yeah, she wasn't sure whether she should just go for the powerful shot or play the loopy forehand topspin. Just caught in a double mind.
Feels like home crowd for Suning Sha right now. Suning Sha, Jayo, they chant. Add oil, or go for it, less literally. Inside the table, Hayata still fighting against that somewhat home court advantage. Singapore is a blend of many beautiful cultures. Good amount of Chinese spoken here. We saw the Chinatown when we came back to the venue. Outstanding food. But a 1-point lead left with Shasha. Oh, out wide as can be, a backhand to be so well prepared. Socially distanced, the crowd in the house right now appreciating every bit of this masterclass from world number two, way out in front for that one. Look how forward her weight is in these shots. Two game points now for a chance to break this into a 3-1 lead. Tight serve. This is from the same player who gave a gift not long ago in a serve. But it goes to show you that when she makes them, the risk pays off.
Yeah. Yingxia just trying to go for the quicker return.
So one game point saved, one more to go for Sun Yingxia. Hino Hayata with the serve. Oh, on the parallel, Xiaxia. Thank you again, Singapore, for the care. Oh, what a punch backhand down the line. Good follow-up, taking it quickly, making sure the ball doesn't drop. She doesn't miss her opportunity.
Yeah, nice serve. She gets the height on the return that she wanted.
Loaded this one with spin. A lot of racket speed from down at about table height.
The first third ball was hit hard. This one. So much of spin, so much of spin and loop.
Nothing too fancy about this, just the looming threat of being in position, knowing what's to come if you don't play it just perfectly. Xiaxia making sure that the rally only started on her terms.
Let two all.
And in the end, the scoreboard doesn't remember if it was a backhand around the net, a diving shot, a smash, or just a controlled push.
Hayata trying to up the pace on her backhand shot that time, and Hayata taking the timeout.
And Xiaxia won 5-4 in the decider. Oh, man. You want to talk about speed limits or what? Ma'am, do you realize how fast you were going on that shot? Pull over. We have to have a little conversation. That was the fastest shot I've seen out of Hino Hayata's forehand, yeah. Either side for that matter.
Yeah, she moved beautifully here. Look at this shot. I mean, Yingxia didn't even get a racket to it. That's how quick it was.
I'm feeling really salty right now. Oh, I mean, it wasn't quite as devastating as the first. It was a little bit behind the table, but this power, I mean, two of the best forehands we've seen from Hino Hayata. What happened in that timeout? What was in the thermos?
Yeah, I told her she needed to play attacking shots, but I didn't think she was going to get two in a row here.
How could you ever imagine that? I mean, it seemed like a one-off, a one-hit wonder. And almost non-stop. Yeah. Good coverage here from Sun Yingxia, but I mean, she came out with three in a row of this forehand.
Yeah, three played cross court. This one was a very, very well played shot, but what reaction from Yingxia.
Yeah, and it got a little bit off the net to break the rhythm on the way back. Mm. So Hayata in the lead. The timeout so far has served her well, but it's her turn to serve to Sun Yingxia.
Let 5-4.
One clear tactic right now is making that first shot really count.
Yeah.
And it's important. I mean, the way you open in any point could determine whether the point continues or not.
Let
You know, you have to take these shots. At times, maybe slowing it down and spinning it, it's easy to see someone miss a shot and think of alternate solutions, but she's been playing so well with these fast forehands and making a high percentage.
Yep.
Good placement on the push right near that back edge. Still scary. I mean, Shasha is so comfortable around that edge. She got good contact on that full stroke forehand from a very difficult place.
Yeah, that was a very well-placed service return going out from the side of the table and made Yingxia try and play that ball at full stretch.
Mm. Second Tomiyage.
Yeah, but how crucial a stage is this? I mean, 6-all, you're trailing by 1-3. She was trying to catch the edge of the table there. I'm going to give her that benefit of doubt.
Trying to catch the edge, I like it. 6-7. Oh, that she did. Well, she succeeded on the second try. I mean, we say this in jest. Aiming for the edge of the table, maybe in an exhibition. The top of the net is a little bit different. I wonder if you asked the best professional in the world, here 100 balls try to hit the edge, and you said, here 100 balls try to make it off the top of the net. I think the net would be the easier one.
Yeah, for sure. Yeah. It's closer to you.
In most cases, yes.
Good attempt by Hayata, though. She wanted to play the backhand punch cross court, just missing.
It's do or die time now for Hina Hayata. Sun Yingxia looking to close the door and get ready for a final. Well, side spin bothers a lot of people, but Sun Yingxia, I mean, she's just so easygoing. Look at this.
Yeah, amazing, amazing backhand.
Hey, Shasha, do you mind if I put some side spin on this receive? No, I'm cool. Whatever you bring, that's fine. Whatever you want. Good power and placement. Hina Hayata with a bit more surprise here after the start of the rally and a timeout now for Shasha. I will say something. The flooring out there is perfect. It's got that layer of softness to protect the knees of the players. It's the standard for all WTT events and ITTF for that matter. I only brought that up because when she bounces the ball, it doesn't come back up as high. Big point here, right out of the timeout. It is now 2 match points for world number 2, Sun Yingxia. Well, Wang Yidi, get ready because the table has been set for 2, the women's singles final tomorrow.